This exercise is a seated variation that mimics the positions and muscles that should be active when you shift your weight over 1 foot. So depending on which side I'm shifting to, so say I'm shifting to my left, I find it's easiest to shift to the left edge of the chair so I can dig my heel back into the chair leg. That lets me more effectively engage my hamstrings than if I'm trying to pull back into nothing. So I'll slide over, get my heel right in front of the chair leg. From here, I'm just going to try to dig both heels back like I'm trying to pull my heels underneath the chair. And especially now, I should feel my left hamstring engage since I'm pulling back into the chair leg. So keeping my hamstrings on, I'm going to just kind of let my pelvis roll back so I feel my sit bones and that my low back is touching the back of the chair. In this position, I'm going to now take my right knee and push it in front of my left. And now I should have, I'd say 65 to 70% of my weight on my left hip versus my right. You'll notice as I'm pulling back and shifting my weight to my left, I'm getting a side bend to the left. And what I'm trying to do is center my nose over my left knee. From this position, I'm going to give a nice exhale and try to push the left side of my low back into the back of the chair. So in this position now, I should feel my left inner thigh, left hamstring, and left abdominal all working with the left side of my low back pressed into the chair. From here, I can reach my left hand down my thigh, keeping the low back flat against the chair. Now hit some breaths here. Should feel a lot of left abdominal engagement. Should keep the left pec nice and quiet. And emphasize a full exhale, keeping those abdominals engaged. What it will look like from the side. So you can see I'm slid all the way back in the chair. I can dig my left heel back into the chair leg. I'm gonna go ahead, shift my right knee forward, shift my weight to my left side, and you'll notice the left side of my low back stays pressed against the chair, even though I'm trying to rotate in the opposite direction. In the seated position, it's going to be tougher to find and feel some of the muscles that you could maybe more easily find laying on your back or laying on your side, but this is an alternative to those exercises, so you can practice this, you know, in your car or, you know, sitting at your desk. You know, an easy way to practice finding and feeling these positions and muscles throughout the day without having to set aside a specific time to set mats up on the floor or something like that. During this exercise, what will be important is that you feel your hamstring, inner thigh, and abdominal all working on the same side, that you emphasize a full, complete exhalation that's going to emphasize appropriate abdominal recruitment, and just making sure that whatever knee I'm shifting back, I'm trying to center my body weight over that hip. So if I'm shifting my left knee back, I'm going to shift my weight over my left hip and essentially try to get my body centered over my left hip and knee. If you have a tough time keeping this knee in as you shift it back, you can use a small ball or a towel roll, something to squeeze into with the knee that you're pulling back. That will prevent it from wanting to go out to the side as you perform that hip shift. Perform this exercise, I would say, 5 breaths on each side, 2 to 3 sets of 5 breaths on each side. And again, it's probably not going to be perfect at first, but knowing these steps, you can practice this easily throughout the day, really in any sitting surface that you encounter, as long as your feet can firmly touch the floor.